Dolly, Miley, or Beyonce, I asked the new chat with a document feature in Amazon Bedrock. Retrieval augmented generation, also known as RAG, lets you bring your own data to generative AI. With this, you get generation that's more predictable and more accurate. To do this, you need to set up knowledge bases and define vector stores and more, which can take a lot of time and resources. Hi, I'm Veliswa, and in this video, I'll show you how the new Chat with Your Document feature in Knowledge Bases for Amazon Bedrock can help you use RAG without the need to set up knowledge bases, saving you time. Now, let's get started. In this demo, we'll first look at how you can set up Chat with Your Document using the AWS console. Then look at how to do this by calling the Retrieve and Generate API in the AWS SDK. I'll be using the Python SDK. My demo answers various questions related to music from the 70s, but more on this later. Before we start, here are a few things to know. You can ask questions on a single document with zero setup. This supports formats such as CSVs, PDFs, text, doc documents. The file size must not be bigger than 10 megabytes, and the file cannot contain more than 20,000 tokens. You can select the document from your chat, either from an S3 bucket or your local device, and Anthropic's Claude 3 Sonnet is the only model that you can use right now with this functionality. Also to know that a text-heavy file, although it can be smaller than 10 megabytes, could breach your token limit. Your document and this data will not be stored after you're done with it. To get started, go to Chat with Your Document tab in Knowledge Bases. I select my model. I mentioned earlier on that Claude 3 Sonnet is the only one that you can select right now. Once I'm done with that, I go to specify where my data is coming from. Is it my computer or S3? I select the S3 and I go to my bucket where I have my document stored. I select my document and I choose that, and I can immediately chat with my document. I start by asking it a few questions. First one's quite predictable, right? Who sang Jolene? You'll be quite amazed at what's gonna come up. It does tell me that it cannot answer that question. It's because that song is not actually in that document. So I ask it another question. Which band topped the charts? Let's see what it says. So with this question that I've asked this time, I do get a response. It's listed a couple of bands there. Queen is there, and a couple other bands listed. Next, let's look at the Python SDK to see how this works with the Retrieve and Generate API. So here I set up a couple of variables. I set up my session, my Bedrock client, and then I go on to set up my model ID. Once I've done that, I also set up the location of the document that I'm going to be looking at. When we look at the Retrieve and Generate API, there are a couple of parameters as well that I'm setting up. As an example, I'm setting up the type as an external source because I'm reading an S3 bucket or a document that's in my local device. And I go on to set up my URI as a document S3 URI that I actually defined earlier on. In this walkthrough, we learned how with the Chat with Your Document feature in Knowledge Bases for Amazon Bedrock, you can bring your own data to generative AI and chat with your document immediately without the need to configure knowledge bases. Learn more by checking out the links that are shared in the description. If you like this video and want more hands-on technical content, be sure to subscribe to the AWS Developers YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.